see, the creation stories of Hinduism also come in two flavors. It's Hinduism got two flavors, please remember. Personality-oriented Hinduism is gods and goddesses. Principle-oriented Hinduism, it doesn't talk about any such super personality, but talks about the nature of reality and what's underpinning to this reality. The creation story that comes out of the personality-oriented Hinduism are very colorful, but of course they cannot stand the test of science or rationality. They collapse straight away. If somebody says, oh, Vishnu was lying on the bed of serpent and from his belly button came out a little lotus flower and it was sitting Brahma, and Vishnu said, Brahma, create, and Brahma, create. Now, if you told this story to your science class in your university, they're going to throw you out. It stands no chance. So it's colorful storytelling. It may have symbolic meaning, but that's all you can say. But the principle-oriented Hinduism has a creation story which fits very well with the ideas of modern cosmology, fits extremely well, incredibly well. Because it says creation comes into being when three things unfold: space, time, and causation. Cause and effect also come with creation. And this fits extremely well with this kind of spontaneous universe and the theory of Big Bang. So if you like, the personality-oriented Hinduism cannot stand up the test of science or rationality, but the principle-oriented Hinduism not only stands up, will give science, modern cosmology, a new twist. Because causality too comes with Big Bangs. You can't say who caused the Big Bang, which is the puzzle for modern cosmologists. You say, don't ask that question. Cause and effect comes with the Big Bang. So the question is irrelevant. Who caused the Big Bang?